You're going to be brought down to hell to the side of the pit. Name of one God. And it's not you, devil.
Yes, amen.
Yeah, he ain't got nobody to stay up and read. He's a vagabond.
Yeah.
Well, he got a place up the roadway, mama. That means
he don't want that place.
The Bible said hell was made for the devil
and his angels.
Not man.
Yes,
not
yeah, and he's not.
But the reason men are going there, because they want to obey God.
Come on.
They reject God. I don't want that. I ain't ready for that. One of these days, huh? Man, we used to win. I remember a lot years ago, we used to win those streets a lot. And so I'll be there one day. Tell them one day.
One day.
See, the devil tell all kind of excuses.
Yes,
huh?
Yes.
I'll be there one day, they dead now. And still didn't come. Huh? See, the devil will cut it. See, the devil won't tell you not to get saved, but he said, wait.
Yes, yes, go come on. On.
Have some fun.
Come on,
see,
come on.
Low. Have a good time. Yeah. I'm going to get away. Let me get you this. I'm through. I remember I was a young man. It was one day the Jehovah's Witness came by the house. I remember it vividly. And they came by, you know, they watched towers and stuff. I told them, I wasn't mad enough. I said, no, no, thank you. I just said, I don't want any. But when they left, I started thinking about God, and I saw myself in a rocking chair. And the devil, now I know talking to him, the devil said, you too young for that. When you get old, I saw a vision of myself in a rocket chair, old man. Yeah, I might not live to be an old man. The devil said later.
Ooh, mercy.
See, he did. But God said now.
Now the supper time. Today. Yeah.
Woo. Now the time.
Yeah.
Separated 6 and 2.
Yes. Now the supper time.
All right. Let's go to the book. Oh. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, and I'm going to begin at verse 15, talking about how we can have the victory, all right?
Amen.
If you ain't got the victory, you can get the victory.
Amen.
Huh? I told you, the Bible said, now, the devil talked to them, tell the devil who you are.
Yeah,
go ahead. I'll tell you something. Psalm 115, verse 15 said, it said, ye are the blessed of the Lord that made heaven and earth. God
yes.
said that about you.
Yeah.
If you're walking upright, though, now there's condition to God promising.
Yeah.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 15, when you got it, say amen. What God said about you, always say that.
Amen,
so
amen.
People speak to you, your body hurting you, you in pain and stuff, and they say, how you doing, sisters? Don't say, well, I guess I'll do it. Don't say that. I guess I'll make it. Don't tell them that. Say, I'm blessed. Tell them what's Psalm 115. Verse 15 say, I'm the blessed of the Lord. I'm blessed. You
are
blessed.
Yeah.
I am blessed.
Yes, 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 yes.
Devil said, your foot hurting or something. Your back hurting.
Come on.
That. I'm blessed. Devil, put the sword to him, huh?
Yes.
Amen. I am what God said I am.
Yes,
all right. This is farming for a victory. Y'all help me. I admire, you know, I was out thinking about y'all. Y'all bring messages. Y'all have them notes and stuff real tidy. And y'all can stay alive. I mean, as a man, as a God, I need to learn how to do that.
Do the way the Lord do you.
Kudos.
Thank you. God bless you.
I said, okay. But anyway, I appreciate it. Man, they do a good job. Y'all do a good job to me. All right?
Yeah.
Verse 15 of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, it says this. See that none render evil or
yes.
evil
yes.
unto any man. Same man,
lost
man, white man.
Right, come on, come
man.
On. That's it.
God said, vengeance is mine.
Yeah.
Give him to God. God said, let him do something if you want to do something.
Yeah.
Don't you get I'm going to get
Jesus,
them.
So God said,
kick my dog, I'm going to kick your cat. Yeah, I'm going to get you. That's what you think you're getting away. I'm going to pay back. But God said, see, I'm going to talk about the victory. That none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good both among yourselves and to all men. Now, among ourselves, I tell you, we got to treat one another right.
Hallelujah. Hey.
Man, sometimes, Lord have mercy. I tell somebody, I always get a nice hug and a good greeting when I speak to them. I love, amen. The Bible said, love you one another.
Yeah.
Man, you talk about, I was thinking about my children, grandchildren. A lot of times, I know y'all with children. Them children cut up sometimes, and then they want to ask you for some money. So you know what I'm saying? What I told you to do, you don't want to give them nothing. But something you end up giving to them. I told you to clean up that so-and-so. You know, you get a thing about that kind of stuff, but you can't. That's something I don't know. I know that out there. Thank you. Feel like, wait a minute. Man, sometimes you want people, I think that some people miss their blessings sometimes out here ugly.
Right. Yeah.
Man, you got to be good. Treat everybody right, huh?
Amen. Amen.
Some folks miss their own blessings sometimes. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Man, read one about, what the Bible says about, it says, read one another with a holy kiss. And I mean a holy kiss. Yeah.
He's saying goodbye.
Yeah. Yeah. Sanctified.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Said, look. Said, ever thought that which is good both among yourselves to all men. Now, here we go. Now, this is Paul. This is an admonition from the Apostle Paul. I said, the greatest of the apostles, if you please, you might differ with that. That's okay. Because he wrote most of the New Testament. God used him more than anybody.
Yeah.
Peter called himself a rock, but one time Paul had rebuked him for being a hypocrite.
Yes,
yes he did.
Because when the Jews came, he wouldn't eat no more pork chops.
Amen.
Paul, and he rebuked him in front of everybody too, to his face.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Causing division, causing dissimulation. That means hypocrisy. That love, the Bible said, be without dissimulation.
Yes.
He said, rejoice. This is the admonition. He said, that great apostle Paul said, rejoice evermore.
More.
I think I lived in Sunday. I don't know if whoever heard, but I said, when you get up in the morning, start singing or saying, say, this is the day. This is the day. The devil tell you all the stuff you got to do today and what all you got to do. All kinds of who you got a fool with, insurance folks, and a whole lot of other stuff. And man, I know how they get on the floor, the folks put y'all home, they out there. Lord, have mercy.
Yeah.
Hey, Mark.
Just this and that. Get the name of the Bible, said rejoice. First thing, wake up, rejoice. Ever, whatever you're going through, whatever you face, rejoice.
Mm-hmm.
That folk ain't gonna treat you right all the time.
Come on.
Now you're fooling yourself, you think that's almost said some nasty stuff. Somebody said something bad to me one time. One of my relatives back here about a month or so ago. Something real bad. You know? Yeah. Man, it's over with. I mean, ain't yeah. Yeah, it's over with. Man, I'm talking, you're gonna be treated fair all the time. You be about in spite of that rejoice. Everyone in the Bible said, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. And if we obey it, God will give us victory.
Hey, God. Yeah, God.
Somebody wrote a song one time. Some of y'all here said, God is watching us from a distance. He closing the net.
Yeah.
He is watching us. Come on. He watching us.
Jesus.
They see what we're going through.
Jesus.
Thank you. What? Behold it.
Good.
Evil. Very good. You see what folks be doing? Don't fight that. Tell God. And you see, God.
Yes,
Lord. Careful, though. He said, rejoice evermore. That's one. For victory. Stop rejoicing.
Hallelujah.
Not complaining. Not murmuring.
Yeah. Come on.
Fussing about everything.
Yeah.
Just Jesus.
And you
Jesus.
But we the blessed. Man, American band say, but we still the blessed nation on the planet.
Yes, 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 yes. Amen. Come on.
Yeah. I remember back during the 60s, some of y'all remember, when all that, remember the hippies and all that, when them folks was out protesting and different stuff. But it used to be a group of guys used to carry flags and wear hard hats. They called them hard hats, the working class. They didn't have all that long hair stuff. They used to tell both America, love it or leave it. Yeah. If you don't like America, go. There's a, here, somebody, I help pay for you a boat to wherever you want to go. Yeah, you don't like this kapok business? Man, we blessed. We don't know how blessed we really are. Man, I went at a job. I go out work sometimes, boy. I drive home sometimes. I stop at the store. When I get out of the car, my baby's, I be like, run the pump, run, throw that. Man, how do you, oh, God. I get this, look at that old man. I get, well, my back is got tight still after. Yeah, but anyway. Yeah, the Bible said rejoice in evermore for everything. I ain't gonna complain.
Yeah.
Verse 17, pray without ceasing. That means don't ever think you give up. Don't ever give up. I told you, I admire praying people. Some people, I listen to them pray. I was saying, man, I wish I could pray. I've been thinking to myself. I do. I was saying, I wish I could pray like that. I'm just thinking to myself now. Yeah. Man, I admire them. There's nothing there. The Bible said, mark the perfect man and behold the upright. Huh? But he and that man of peace in the heart. He give me many good things. People, praise God. When that people betray the side, man, I wish I could pray. They be praying and man. I didn't mean to man, that was out of play right there, but the Bible said pray without ceasing.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know it's praying time.
Yes.
I don't know you talking about so long. Oh. Praying time.
Yes, yes.
Man, we in the epoch talking about the evil day. The evil day is here.
Yeah.
And it's gonna get worse.
Yes.
Yes. Excuse me.
Yes,
now you talking about praying. Wake up in the morning praying.
Yes, sir.
Go to praise God. You're driving. Pray.
Yes, sir.
Pray. Pray without ceasing.
Jesus.
Don't ever give up. Mm-hmm. Don't quit. Mm-hmm. Man, the prayer don't seem to be worth stop fasting.
Mm.
Turn the plate down.
Yes.
Man, God, I tell you, God, watch it. I tell you, telling God, oh, God, do this and do that, and I want this. Man, God don't see how much it was. God, listen, that's it. See, you tell, when you got there, that plate, that's I'm going to have to do something now.
Yeah.
See, that's the way of humbling yourself. I think that in Psalm 35 and 10, David said, I humble my soul fast. Look, this isn't humility. You mean somebody with one of them old timid personalities? That's not humility. You know what I'm saying? That's not humility. Humility is an act of the will of humbling yourself before God.
Yes.
I listened to somebody talking about one of Solomon's son had sinned, and God had put him in bondage and took him to Babylon. But now he humbled himself and started fasting. And God turned his captivity. He did all kind of evil. Killing David and worshiping the stars and the moon and everything. But when he humbled himself and saw God, God let him go. Keep on praying.
Glory.
Keep on praying.
Mm-hmm.
Pray without ceasing.
Yes,
come on. And then, in verse 18, in everything.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm saying it. In everything, whatever you in.
Yes.
In everything.
Yes,
give thanks.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
You want to know the will. God, I want to know your will. This is his will.
The will of God concerning
you.
Yellow.
In everything.
Glory to
God. Okay, what then? In everything. Give thanks. You know something? I've learned a few things over the years. I've learned how to keep my mouth shut. When people talking evil and saying stuff. Oh, you said that to them. I know what I'm dealing with, see?
Amen.
I ain't mad. I know what I'm dealing with.
Lord,
that spirit wants you to bust and fight back.
Yeah.
I ain't even talking to her. I'm talking to the devil.
Hmm.
You got to know, huh? Devil wants you to fight back.
Yes.
Come on. Yep.
I'm going to keep my mouth and zipping.
Jesus.
You can't control your tongue. But this thing is a deadly poison.
Full of death.
Get to kill one of that tongue.
You know.
Said one more word. That guy wasn't playing. Started him. Yeah. Kill it. Said one more thing.
Yeah.
All he had to do was just kill his mouth still.
Yeah.
You don't know. Bam. Real, that's the real stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna keep my mouth and be quiet sometimes.
Study to be quiet. Mm-hmm. That's the word.
The Bible said the multitude of words that one is not seen. That means, in other words, you keep talking. People talk out on their business, get themselves in trouble.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
Oh, your peace.
Yeah.
Woo! Come on.
Man, you know what? We like noise. You know, some people, they gotta have something going, some racket going on all the time in the house.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta have the radio. I know there's a sister down in Houston, Sister Butter. She was a sweet sister. She used to work, she used to live close where I worked there. I would stop by her house. She's real sweet. But she used to have the TV on, the radio. Sometimes she had the TV and the radio on. And be reading the Bible, up there, they're okay.
How do you hear? Woo! Come on.
She was multitasking. Bonnie was multitasking. I said, nah, how is she getting that thing? She got all this noise going. You know, the Bible said, be still. Be still.
Mm-hmm.
And know
that I am God.
Woo!
Glory to God.
Sometimes you thank God in a lot of rest. But the Bible said he was in a still, small voice. Huh? Yeah,
mm-hmm.
When the earthquake is, oh, that got to be God. And the wind blowing, he wasn't in none of that. But that's a still, small voice.
Come on. Hallelujah.
And everything. I'm talking about everything, give thanks.
Yes.
So this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Whatever you in, whatever you're doing, whatever you're going through, give thanks.
Yes.
Don't complain. It ain't gonna help you.
So well. Yeah.
Come on. Somebody said, told me, heard one time said, a worry is like being in a rocket chair. Give you something to do, but you don't get anywhere.
Hey.
And so, what's the point? You ain't going. You can rock all day. You ain't going. So stop worrying.
Yeah,
no. Don't help nothing. Now, stop. If you do something, that do something.
Wow.
No, you can't give it to God and go ahead. Go home. Go to sleep.
Your shadow. Yeah.
Man. And everything. Come on, let's give God thanks.
Hallelujah. Glory, thank you, God.
This is the will of God. Christ Jesus concerning you, that means all of us. Ain't no son of preacher, the pastor, the evangelist, the church mommy, everybody. And everything, that means everybody. No back door, no shortcut, y'all. Got to walk down the same room, huh?
Ah, yeah.
Find the same thing.
Mind the same thing.
And then, verse 90 said, quench not the spirit.
Ha, ha.
Lord, help us. Help me.
Yes.
Mm. Share this up with you. Years ago, brother, I know some of y'all remember Brother Coleman. We used to go out on the street and street witness and preaching and whatnot. I used to be out of town sometimes, but I had a fear of sorts of people with briefcases, especially white people that looked at Taylor, you know, carrying them lawyer types. I had this a phobia, sir. It was the devil. I'm over that now. The devil told me, said, the folks intelligent. They ain't gonna listen at you. I wouldn't witness to them either. I mean, I'm kind of. I'm talking about quitting the spirit.
Yes.
Don't quit it.
Amen.
I was quitting the spirit. Amen. God loved them too.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care. They lost.
They'll give you how to speak to
them. I got over there. I got the victory. Show you what happened one night. Long time ago, Brother Terry, he was working at the airport. I'm talking about quenching the spirit. I had got over there and show you what happened. I took him to the airport for him to go to work and dropped him off on the way out. There was a man sitting on the desk there at the airport. He was looking through his papers and stuff. I guess he was waiting on the place as a white man for what it's worth. I mean, but I used to be afraid of the type. And on the way out, I didn't know he was going to be there in the Lord, so go talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
Witness to him. And I went over there and said to him, how you doing, sir? I thought about where he was headed and stuff. He said something. I don't remember everything verbatim. And I started talking to him about the Lord, and he was just listening. And there, he asked me, he said, what school did you go to? Now, what happened, it was God got in it. God showed me what happened over the book of Isaiah. He told Isaiah, I'll give you the tongue of the learned that you might help him who is weary. But because I had lost that fear of those type of people, I was able to get through to that man. He was impressed about what I said. It wasn't me. It was God. Because I lost that fear. I didn't quench that spirit anymore when it comes to those type of intellectual looking folks. So because of him, I hope to see him in glory one day.
Hallelujah.
Don't quench the spirit. God tell you to do something, do it. The devil, what they gonna think? The devil, what they gonna think? What God gonna think? People worry about what folk think. I'm worried about what God gonna think. Don't quit the spirit,
Despise not prophesy. All right, man. Don't despise prophesy. Not prophesy come forth.
Don't despise it. Don't say it ain't God. Just wait. If God, I'm very careful about telling stuff, people about what God. I told somebody one time about a dream I had. I just talked to him now. I knew, I said, now this God is going to come to pass. If it ain't, it's just something I ate or something. every time you dream something, don't mean it's God. The Bible said dreams come through a multitude of men. I remember I used to do production, brother, trying to make these toolboxes go across the back of pickup truck. They were metal. And I used to do that all night long. Sometimes I'd come home and lay down and I could see myself still welding because my mind been doing it all night. And you get to thinking about stuff, you might dream about it. Every kind of prophecy is not necessarily of God. Some prophecies are presumptuous.
Yes.
People got an opinion and they thinking stuff.
Yes.
They got good intentions, but if it's God, it's going to come to pass. When they prophesy, don't despise this way. It's going to come to pass. Don't despise prophesying. A prophesying may be something in the future, but it could be something right now. This is prophesying, if you please. See, a prophet is not necessarily somebody that's all, we're talking about something going to happen in the future.
Tell you
all right. Don't despise prophesy. All right, Now watch this. Prove all things. Hold fast to that which is good. When the Lord first saved me, he told me this. He said, son, he said, that thing you heard about my word, you just gonna have to forget. Now, let me tell you why he told me that. Because people said, you know, the Bible said, and the Bible ain't said nothing. I'm telling you, prove all things. The Bible said, examine, prove all things. That's right. You try the spirit by the word. By the word.
Amen.
Prove all things. I don't believe, when I hear something, when somebody says something I don't know about, I go get my Bible.
Yes.
So wait a minute. When people start preaching, I'm listening intently. The Bible said, prove all things. You gotta be scared. Get the book out. This old preacher used to say, get the book. He said, get the book. Let's get the book. We'll see who right and wrong. The Bible said, prove all things. I don't believe everything. The Bible said in 1 John 4, beloved, believe not every spirit. But try the spirits, whether they are God, because many false prophets gone out to the world, a whole lot of them.
Yes.
Telling folks, trying to get us back under the law. First fruit offering and all this kind of stuff. We ain't under no law, but righteousness,
Amen.
The Bible said, prove all things.
Yes.
Prove it. Come on.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. And prove all things.
All
right, and we have victory. Say, hold fast to that which is good. Now, abstain from all appearance of evil. Anything look evil, you have to watch this. I have to watch myself sometimes. And one time, long time ago, this something happened in Houston now. I used to drive the van. I could see real good then. I didn't need no glass. But anyway, I was there. I was taking folks home. And I just, it was a sister came there. I was taking her home, but
She happened to live in a part of town where this restaurant was that I liked. And they had that good salt and pepper shrimp, and I had to stop. I said, man, I thought I'm going to go to that business. Well, I went in and got some table out. And lo and behold, I'm sitting there with the sister, and saw a couple of church members came in there and saw me in there with her. And I get down to church that night, and Pastor Whitfield called me an offer. Talking about somebody. Spend some stuff. Now, you know, see, but that was all there. I wasn't doing nothing. You try to avoid some stuff, you can't stop people from thinking evil, but then do your best you can. Some stuff gotta stay away from, huh? And stay from all appearance of evil. Some stuff we ain't got no business looking at. I got my radio at work where I can listen to it. A lady come on. She was talking about, I forget the name of this magazine. She said it, this magazine contained pornography. And she talking about young folk is reading it. And it's bad for the young people. It's bad for the old folk too.
Come on.
It's bad for the old folk. It's bad for the old folk. Trying to protect the young folk. Pornography is nasty. Tender people, huh? All appearance, sometimes we ain't got no business looking at. Well, it's up to us. Sometimes I look at TV and I see something, I flip the child. Man, the devil gets you in trouble. That's how you got Eve trust him looking at. Don't that look good? Look at that, dude. The devil talk, look how pretty. Ain't that pretty? Lust of the eyes, huh? Lust of it makes you wise, like I see God holding back on y'all. See, you know. If y'all eat that, you be wild like him. So you don't want, that's why he told y'all not to eat it.
You like open God.
All right, understand from all purity, some stuff, we ain't got no business touching. Touching out the unclean thing.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. And I don't smoke. I ain't got no need of smoking. Folks call it Chris. I heard a preacher say one time, I'll be through in a minute, told somebody, said, he asked some questions. Somebody wrote and said, well, if I smoke cigarettes, will I go to hell? And he said, no, but you'll smell like it. Now he called himself trying to be funny. Now, ain't nothing funny. Now he called trying to be funny. The Bible said, no, you're not. So who said, I'll tell you what happened to me when I got saved. I didn't know smoking was wrong. I did not. One day I was reading that scripture you talked about when they said, no, you're not, that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which you have. And God said, if any man defile this temple, him with God destroy. When I read that, I said, oh, man. I dropped off, didn't nobody knock. I said, woe is me, like Isaiah. And man, I was having a struggle with them things. And but I remember one morning, I was going to work. I was riding the bus. And I got off the bus, and I suddenly realized I didn't want no more cigarettes. It was gone. God took it. I mean, I didn't have a desire. I didn't know I was wrong. Somebody said you wasn't saved. Yes, yeah, you saved. That's why he said, put away stuff from you lying. You were talking to folk that had been saved.
That's it.
I tell them, put away that stuff. Straighten them out. But anyway, whatever it is. Abstain from all appearance of evil. And if you do this, then the very God of peace sanctify you holy and be complete. And I pray, God, this is Paul's desire to us. Pray, God, your whole soul.
Yes.
Now, you can't see that. You can see that, the body. Your whole spirit. You can't see my spirit, my soul, but you can see my body, huh? Be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Listen, faithful is he that calleth you, who also shall do it in his sins by his brethren. Pray for us. I'm talking about getting the victory, keeping the victory. Pray.
Yeah, you keep the victory. Hallelujah.
Every morning, everything, give thanks for this is the will of God.
Yes.
Christ Jesus. I'm saying, don't complain.
Hallelujah.
God said, keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on. Press on. Don't give up.
Yes,
God, open another door. You know what I found out? Sometimes we being intent on trying to do stuff, and God don't want you to do it. He got something better for you. You're going to make God, you're going to make this thing work. It's like somebody got a square peg. They gonna make
trying to fit in a round hole.
I'm going to get my knife, and you going in this hole. That's what you do. God don't want you to go that way.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
God will lead you in the right way. Yes. If we do these things, we'll have the victory and everything. Praise God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
Praise God. Let's obey God. Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
That around, pray God. Father, we thank you tonight for these few moments to stand before your people now. To stand one more time.
Yes, yes, yes.
Let your word take root in our hearts.
Yes.
Let us be born.
Hallelujah.
Not just here, but on the so let your love abide in our hearts. Yes. Let your love continue among
yes,
us,
yes,
God.
Yes.
Fervently, O God. In Christ Jesus' name, we thank you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.